Hello everyone. Yesterday we discussed about semiconductors. What is semiconductors, conductor and insulator, and intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsics are classified into two types, p-type and n-types. What is p-types and what is n-type? P-type is impurity atoms and n-type is a p-type is a impurity atom, but it is an acceptor atom. And n-type is a it is an impurity atom, but it is a donor atom. And today we learn about Jenner diode. Without wasting any time, let's begin.
The principle of standard diode. But there are different types of diode that have different properties. We are going to take look at the Jenner diode and what make different from a standard diode. So if you watch my you will know that the basic principle of diode is that they allow current to flow in only one direction. If I were to reverse the direction of diode, putting it into reverse bias to flow through the current, a power supply across it. And the exactly what is the Jenner diode is doing. When this diode is reverse bias, it preventing and current flowing through the circuit. In this sense, Jenner diode work exactly like standard diode, with the exception of one thing. Jenner diode have a specified reverse breakdown voltage, also known as the Jenner voltage. And what this means is, if you reverse bias a Jenner diode, it will prevent in a circuit only up to a certain voltage. So the Jenner diode is currently reverse bias and is preventing current flowing through the circuit. This Jenner diode has a specific breakdown voltage of 10 volts and I am currently supplying 5 volts to the circuit. So in this case, current is not flowing through the circuit. However, let's have a look what happened when I increase the voltage to the circuit above the Jenner diode breakdown voltage. As you can see, as I move the above 10 volts, current start to flow through the circuit because the Jenner diode breakdown voltage has been exceeded. Now if you are thinking, well, what's the point of having a diode that can conduct in both direction? Well, a Jenner diode can come in very useful for creating voltage references, shunt voltage regulators and over voltage protection circuit. So let's have look at awesome example of how Jenner diode can be useful in a circuit. Take a look at this circuit. I have a 12 volt power supply with reverse bias Jenner diode. It is reverse breakdown voltage is 10 volt. So therefore the breakdown voltage has been exceeded by 12 volt power supply, thus allowing the current to flow the circuit. I have voltmeter on the side here and it's measuring 9.94 volt. Let's have look at what happens when I increase the voltage of the power supply. So I have increased the voltage of this power supply to 51 volt, but look at the voltage across the Jenner diode. It is still approximately 10 volt. So how exactly has this just happened? I am supplying 51 volt to the circuit exceeding the Jenner diode reverse breakdown voltage. The Jenner diode still only has 10 volt across.